The county commissioner tells Channel 2 Action News that crews working on a massive gas pipeline project violated state and federal laws. Channel 2's Michael Bushner is live and coming with the action crews just took minutes ago after that commissioner arrived there. Mike?
Joe Vita, I can tell you within the last couple hours, the last cleanup crew left this site, but take a look behind me here. It's a lot cleaner compared to what it looked like when we arrived. They were here all day. You could see they filled in blacktop. They tried to clean up the dirt. This after that county commissioner came out here with grave concerns. You could see the project. You could see this home right now. This is where the viewer is that gave us a call, concerned about their front yard. This is perfectly legal, though, with the front yard missing, essentially, from this project. That's because Atlanta Gaslight does have an easement, but residents who live here say this construction has been going on way too long. For 6 weeks, Sherry Sands has lived with the rumble of heavy machinery and this mess.
I worry every single time that equipment goes by, that if they're going to swing, miss, drop it, slam into my home.
Sands told us what Atlanta Gaslight promoted as a 1 to 2 week project has dragged on for more than a month and a half. Crews are replacing an aging gas pipeline that stretches for more than a dozen miles in Forsyth County, and it just so happens to cut across Sands' front yard.
We've tried to just stay away. It's hard to get in and out.
Fed up, Sands called her county commissioner.
It looks like they're being somewhat disrespectful to the soil erosion codes as well as to the residents in this district.
Within minutes of Forsyth County Commissioner Todd Levent arriving at the scene, we watch crews begin to clean up the dirt and storm drains and bring the job site back into compliance.
All of this soil's in the street, in my opinion, violates some of the state and federal laws as well as our local ordinances.
But by the time the shovels hit the asphalt, it was too late. The county issued a written warning to Atlanta Gaslight to clean up their act and the job site.
The amount of dirt in the street, and it's the worst I've seen in any intersection, maybe because this one's in a cul-de-sac hidden in the back. They just got a little more lax.
It's the American dream to buy a house, and you work hard to have a nice home, and then to have this in your front yard day after day after day.
Now, within the last half an hour, we did receive a statement from Atlanta Gaslight, and it reads, in part, we have spoken with the homeowner and are working to address her concerns. While we do our best to anticipate timing of our pipeline projects, as with all construction plans, there are various factors that could affect the scheduled start and completion dates. The statement went on to say that we apologize for the inconvenience to this homeowner, and they promised to promptly wrap up their work pretty soon. When I spoke to that homeowner, she told me this afternoon that she was told by the county commissioner here that this work should wrap up within the next couple days. But now we're live in Forsyth County. Michael Butchner, Channel 2 Action News.